All three suspects are now in the Sacramento County Jail. Fox 40's Zach Boetto joins us live outside the jail to break down what Peyton's lawyer had to say and how other legal experts are also weighing in tonight. Zach.
Yeah, Nikki, Eric, Matula Peyton's lawyer says his client does have a defense, and it looks like it's going to be self-defense. But it's all going to come down to what evidence is brought to light, including what that Sacramento Police Department surveillance camera caught on the corner of K Street and 10th Street on April 3rd.
43 through 48, Peyton.
With Matula Peyton making his first court appearance in Sacramento today, we're hearing from his lawyer and learning how self-defense may be the defining factor in who will be convicted.
The details of who did what and when and who did what first, what circumstances were presented to Mr. Peyton, if he fired and when he fired, what was he dealing with at that time, that's all very relevant to whether or not he has a valid self-defense.
Peyton arrived in Sacramento this week after he was arrested in Las Vegas on May 28th with the help of the FBI and the Las Vegas Metro Police. He was put in cuffs just 8 weeks after the K Street mass shooting, which left 6 dead and 12 injured.
This was a gun battle between rival gang members who came armed to this scene in downtown Sacramento, and innocent bystanders died.
One defense attorney says Peyton's decision to flee to Las Vegas could be perceived as implied guilt, but his lawyer says different.
It can be implied guilt, but it can also be an indication of fear, right? Whether or not you're justified in shooting and killing somebody or not, you might still be scared because all lights are on you, right? Everybody's attention on you and is on you, and it can be overwhelming.
Regardless of Peyton's flight risk, legal experts say conviction will all come down to the video showing all three suspects, brothers Smiley and DeAndre Martin and Matula Peyton, who were at the scene, in order to determine who shot first, who shot who, and if there was necessary intent to kill.
If somebody else shot first in California, you are allowed to use reasonable force to protect yourself against that. And that can include deadly force. So in theory, if somebody shot at them, there is a viable defense to shoot back.
And Trigger says even though he had prior felony charges, having a gun and using it to kill does not eliminate your chances of self-defense.
And that counts even if you have, for example, an illegal firearm, if you're not supposed to be in possession of a firearm, potentially because, for example, you're a felon. In emergency or self-defense type situations, you can actually still do that.
Peyton's lawyer, Michael Wise, says the same and says now there will be vigorous research done on the video showcasing the events leading up to, during, and after the mass shooting that took the lives of 6 people in downtown Sacramento.